What's up? Welcome back to the channel. I don't know what I just did with my hands. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make beats and melodies for Polo G, how you guys can make something similar, and how to just capture that vibe. So yeah, stick around for that. I'll play you guys the beat at the end. And before we get started, 25% off all the kits in the description. If you're new, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And without further ado, let's get straight into the video. All right, so I have a piano selected here, and I'm just gonna play out a little pattern. We're gonna kind of space the chords out, put some lower notes so we can kind of make it feel fuller. We're gonna copy and paste one down. And then we're gonna lower these velocities with Alt X and then turn it down. And that's gonna make it like sound more delicate, emotional, and just way better. Like, listen to that. And then you hear the contrast here. Granted, this doesn't have lower notes yet, but you hear the difference. Okay, so we need to add more notes to kind of fill the chords in just real quick. Okay, so let's add some top notes. All right, so I'm gonna add in just a hi-hat and a clap just to speed up the process, get the feel going. I mess with this bounce, but like we need to change up some of the pattern. All right, so now let's go ahead and add an 808, and then we're gonna continue on with the melody, I think, and then we'll finish off the drums later. So we can basically copy this bass line, then we'll just change the timing of the notes. Okay, so what we need to do is add this to a mixer track and take out some of the lows so that way they don't clash. And then we're gonna turn up this 808 and pitch it down. Okay, so we have like the foundation of everything. Now we need to make some like ambient stuff that really like just enhances that sad vibe. Let's edit this D note. I think we're gonna pitch it down. Listener with the open eye, like you expected to be here too, but it's not. Sounds fire. And then we'll have. The kick's just gonna come in like whenever it feels like it, really. Just not often, not as often as you would think it would. Thank you. like that note change right there. Okay, so I want to add some notes to like make the melody feel like it's moving more. Pitch it up. Pitch it up, pitch it up, pitch it up. Hey, pitch it up, hey, pitch it up. Ooh. See how these like lingering notes just add not only like movement but more emotion, especially these two notes right here. All right, let's see if we can find like an arcade bank or something that has like some type of guitar, maybe something. Ooh, that might be hard. Not the little like none of that. I think the part before that might be fire though. Yeah, that might be hard. Hold up. And then we're gonna turn that part down. This might sound fire, but I think we pitch it to a different pitch. Ooh, wait, it might be fire right there. And then I think we create another one. Yeah, I'm onto something. So it's gonna be the same note, and we're gonna pitch it down to a different pitch. Yeah, that's gonna be hard. And then we gotta fix the pitch for this one. I think it's the next one too. That's so sad. We're gonna record this. And then we'll just pitch it ourselves. We'll cut everything but this. So play the melody. Ooh, that's fire. That sounds like it's like singing almost. I'm also gonna add everything to the mixer track, put a little compressor on here so it's louder. Yeah, fire. That's so hard. And then we're gonna EQ a little bit of lows out. Alright, so I'm gonna play you guys a beat. So yeah, now to sum up the video, how to really achieve the sound is you want a piano or a guitar, some good guitar plugins or ample guitar. I know Philharmonix has a guitar. I'm not sure how good it is. Don't mind my dog. The piano or the guitar is like a must have for the Polo G tracks. And then after that, after you establish a chord progression or just a pattern with one of those two sounds, you wanna switch over to something that's gonna give you ambience. Now that's a broad category because you can literally cut out highs and throw on reverb for a bunch of different sounds and it'll give it ambience. But yeah, you're just gonna wanna capture ambience, and how you're gonna do that is by cutting out highs and adding reverb to the sounds. But yeah, that's it. That's how you capture the vibe. And then for the drums, you really just want to keep them simple, and hopefully you guys learned some. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Let me know if you can hear Polo G on this in the comments below. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe, turn on notifications, hit that like button if you enjoyed. It really helps out the channel. And yeah, I'm gonna play you guys a beat. Here's the beat. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video.